In this video, I'm going to teach you how we're going to code indicator on NinjaTrader. NinjaTrader is a very powerful trading platform. If you have been trading on MT5 or MT4, you should also download NinjaTrader and install it on your computer. NinjaTrader is very powerful as compared to MT5 and MT4. NinjaTrader uses C#. C# is a very powerful object-oriented programming language that has been developed by Microsoft. So if you want to code indicators in NinjaTrader, you should know C#. Knowing C# can give you many other skills also. With C# you can develop websites, you can develop mobile apps, you can develop games, you can do AI, so you can do many things. Xamarin Forms on C# allow you to code a mobile app that works on Android, iPhone, iPad. So you see, it's a very powerful programming language. So let's start. This is the NinjaTrader code editor. So if you want to code an indicator, first you will have to right click on this indicator folder and then click on this new indicator in this new indicator, and then you will just name your indicator. I've already done it, and this indicator has been I've named it the MACD color. So we can also open this code in Visual Studio. So let's do it. This is first, let me show you. This is the NinjaTrader chart. It's very powerful. This is the 10-hour chart. You can use any custom time frame you want. And then just to open that chart, I have used this 10-hour. This is that MACD, default MACD that has been provided. And see, the pound dollar chart, 10 hour, huge move, then there's a huge move. This is the time when Russian army invaded Ukraine. So see, pound dollar fell strongly. So let's quote that indicator. Now I've opened this code in Visual Studio. First is using declarations. Then we have this namespace. Namespace just helps you organize your code. Namespace is just a collection of libraries. So it helps you organize your code in a better way. Namespace is NinjaTrader NinjaScript Indicators. I have given the summary, MACD moving average, convergent averages is a trend indicator. Trend following momentum indicator that shows the recent two moving averages, just for information. Then I've declared the variable private series double MACD histogram. So series is a time series that NinjaTrader uses NinjaScript framework. NinjaScript is a C# based framework that defines this series object. Series object implements this I series interface. You should have the concept of what is an interface. Then on state change method, description, MACD indicator paints green bar when the momentum increases, paints red bar when the momentum decreases. And this is the name that calculate on bar close. So this is just, this indicator is going to just calculate once when the bar closes. So if we are on a 10 hour chart, just after 10 hour when the bar closes, it will make that calculation. And for the next 10 hours, there will be no calculation. So it helps reducing this computational burden on the computer. Is overlay false? Yes, we don't want to overlay this indicator on a chart. So display in data box, true, drawn, price panel. So these things, we just tell what we want. Now we say we have defined these properties, fast 12, slow 26, smooth 9. Add plot, new stroke, brushes, green, 4, plot style. So we have defined this add plot, 4 add plots. And this is add line. In the state down data loaded method, we load this data. If I'm new series double this, this means we are just refreshing it this itself. And this is that main on bar update where the main logic of the indicator will be executed. So if the current bar is less than slow, that means the 20, let's check what the slow is. Slow is 26, so if less than 26 bars, so it will just return. First, it will make sure that we have got 26 bars. And the MACD histogram is MACD. We are using that default MACD. Fast, slow, smooth, zero, minus, dot, average, zero. Zero is just the recent bar. When it closes, then this calculation will take place. So MACD histogram is MACD histogram one. MACD histogram one is greater than zero. And then we define this two variable MACD u one. Same way this MACD histogram define it. So we have coded this indicator and these are the properties. NinjaScript property, display name fast, description number of bars, applicant fast. NinjaScript property range, number of bars for slow EMA. This property browsable fast means we can't access it. This is for internal consumption. Series double MACD get return. So you should have the concept of properties. Properties are very important in C# object oriented programming. So I've coded these things and this is that code that generates neither change nor remove. So this is caching the whole thing, cache MACD code, but it says you should not change this code. So once we have coded this MACD color indicator, we have to build it using this thing, command. And now we have built it. So let's now go and check our indicator. We had coded the MACD color indicator. So let's check. It looks on the chart. So here, this is that default MACD and this is what we have coded. See, when the momentum goes strong in up direction, it paints a green bar. When it goes strong and down direction, it paints a red bar. We can where this is the indicator list, many indicators that we can use. Let's remove this indicator default. Now let's see if this is, from here you can choose a different time. So I will use 600 minutes, that is 10 hours. You can use 16 hours, you can use whatever you want. 2 days, just converted to minutes. So this is how we go to put indicators on NinjaTrader. I hope you like this video. One thing that I forgot to mention was this, that you should download the NinjaTrader help guide. It's available on the internet. So let's do that. I have already downloaded this thing. First go to this NinjaTrader website. Click on this link, type NinjaTrader manual PDF in the Google bar. Now this thing, click on this NT8 PDF. Here, I was talking about the series T. So this defines everything. Series T is a special generic type of data structure. And it implements the iSeries T interface. So if you want to learn how to code indicators on NinjaScript, then you should download this PDF manual. It's roughly like more than 3000 pages. So it defines everything, creating series T objects, so setting values, checking for valid. There's a long list. On bar update, I mentioned that on bar update, and event driven method is called whenever bar is updated. The frequency, we term the calculate property. So this manual will show you many things that you can, if you find difficulty in coding the indicator, you can always reference this manual. See, drawing tool, draw and draw objects. If you use a global drawing tool, so this is what example, finding the draw object of a specific tag. So in future also, I'll explain in detail few more indicators that we will code in NinjaTrader using C#. And then we also code some trading strategies and then backtest them. If you want personal coaching, you can always contact me. I hope you like this video.